Hey crew, welcome back to another episode of Checking In With Your Coach. On the last episode, we started to talk about volume and how to deal with what a week looks like, what a month looks like, and we'll continue to do that in a later episode. Today, we're talking about intensities. And what I want to cover are some of the easier ways you guys can add and change your intensity. So remember, volume is the amount of weight lifted times the amount of repetitions, and if you really want to get into it, the distance it travels. But we can adjust repetitions, sets, things like that, and we can change the volume. But amongst and in that volume, we can actually change the intensity. So intensity to a lot of people can be just adding more weight. So that's usually the easiest way to make things a little bit more intense, is simply just to add more weight to things. Now that does change the amount of volume, which is one way to help your body change, which we talked about in the last episode. But other intensities that are, again, easy for you guys to manipulate is rest, okay? So if you rest for longer periods of time, you can usually deal with more volume and more intensity. Now that rest can be in a workout, so maybe you're taking 2 to 3 minute breaks, whatever it is, or it can actually be, when is the next time I'm gonna squat? When is the next time I'm gonna do, you know, a shoulder press or whatever it is that you're working on? So some people, what they do is they give themselves a whole week before they squat, deadlift, press, whatever it is. Other people, what they'll do is every third day or every second day or, you know, whatever. By just changing that, you're changing how much rest you're getting, and that changes how much intensity it is on your body. So let's say on a Monday, you're able to bench press, you know, 200 pounds for 8 repetitions or whatever. And then you come back on Friday or Thursday and you try to do sets of 8 again, but now it's only 150 pounds because you didn't get enough rest in between, which it can be an appropriate thing if you're planning on it. And that can be one way to change it. So the frequency of your exercise throughout the week. Again, also rest intervals in your workout. Another thing you can do is tempo. Okay, so instead of, let's say on a squat, descending, you know, 1, 2, you hit the bottom and you stand up, 1, 2. Instead of having that traditional, typical tempo, you could add some, you know, maybe you reduce the speed on the way down. Maybe you add a pause at the bottom. Maybe you purposefully come up slower. You could do all of those. You could do one of those. Those can really change the intensity and reduce the amount of repetitions that you actually have to do in order to change your body. So let's say typically you respond to higher volume. The tendency there is you respond to higher volume due to the fact that it's more time and more time under tension that your body is under. So rather than doing 6 repetitions, what if you did 3, but you slowed the descent of your squat and slowed the ascent of your squat? That way you may not even have to use the same amount of weight. You don't have to do as many repetitions, and you might be able to come back to it at a different time, okay? Again, adding pauses can certainly make the intensity a little bit different. Certainly, you can add chains, and you can add different barbells, and just changing where the position of a bar is can certainly change the intensity. So let's say you're doing squats. You could have a really heavy bar on your back. You could have a bar on your front. You could use dumbbells. You could put dumbbells above your head. Changing the angle of the exercise can change the intensity too. So for most people, they can squat the most weight when the bar is on their back. Okay, so what is that doing? It allows you to add more weight to your body, making the squat heavier. But for some people, putting it over their head gives their body a different change, right? If they're looking to get leaner, maybe putting the bar over their head gets them leaner faster than putting it on their back, because there's so many other elements to it. But again, intensity is more than just the amount of weight you put on the bar. And I hope that these few things that we talked about, and again, we didn't talk about mechanical overload, we didn't talk about isometric holds, we didn't talk about any of that because that's more advanced type stuff. But again, add a little pause, change your rest intervals, and again, certainly changing the weight. Those are some easier ways that you guys can change the intensity so that your body doesn't adapt to the stressor too quickly, and you guys can still see those results. So get out there and change some intensity.